I'm Nick Leister from the SolidWorks training team. xShape is a subdivisional surface tool for creating complex, organic shapes. However, it can also reference existing geometry for some of its operations. In this video, I'll show you how to use xShape to create a finger grip for a pair of pliers with the net surface and combine commands in a process that produces complex yet reliable models. Let's get started. Here, I have the pliers assembly open in xDesign. And though it's possible to create new geometry in this environment, I'll close and save this assembly because it will be easier to create the finger grip in a new part environment. Now, I'll bring in the geometry that I'll reference for the finger grip. I'll browse to the Assembly tab, click Insert Component, and select the handle for pliers part. I'll switch to the xShape app. Parts designed in xShape always start with a primitive shape, which you manipulate as needed. Here, I'll select Net Surface Primitive, which will allow me to reference the model's edges. I'll select two edges under Profiles and one under Guides, where the finger grips will be. I'll enter 3 for the divisions in this direction. I'll enter 8 for the divisions going this way, which will produce 9 nodes, enough for each finger groove. I want to keep this component symmetrical, so I'll show the planes and enable symmetry along this plane. This process creates another set of nodes along the plane. I'm ready to start manipulating the primitive. I'll start by making the finger grooves. I'll zoom through the steps for manipulating the primitive, but if you want a detailed breakdown of how to use these features, check out the xShape learning path, linked below. Once I'm happy with the way it looks, I'll click Accept Subdivision. The finger grip part will need to be cut to fit over the handle part, which I'll do with a surface derived from the handle's geometry. Hiding the subdivisional shape will make it easier to create the surface body we'll use to cut the finger grip part. The offset command, with the distance set to 0, is ideal for creating the surface body. Once I select all the faces that contact the subdivisional surface body, I'll click OK. Hide the handle part and show the subdivisional surface body. The combine feature, with subtract enabled, helps create this cut. The part looks great, so I'll save and close the part and open the pliers assembly in xDesign. Now I can insert the finger grip part, add mates, and apply a covering material for its appearance. A palm grip part can be made following a similar process. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this content helpful, visit the site below to access a video-based learning path on designing with xShape.